Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let me show you how to stop the Photos app and iTunes from automatically launching when you plug in your iPhone or other devices. So this has got to be one of the most common questions that Mac users have. When you plug in an iPhone or an iPad or even a just regular digital camera, apps sometimes launch by themselves. For instance, the Photos app, or before that iPhoto, would just launch automatically, assuming that you want to import new photos from these devices. And also sometimes iTunes will automatically launch and begin syncing an iPhone or iPad. Now, a lot of people want to do this manually. They don't want to have to have these apps automatically launch every time they plug these devices in. Well, stopping this behavior is pretty easy. So let's look at the Photos app first. And you may think right away, I should go to maybe preferences, maybe there's a setting in here to not launch photos automatically when I connect a device. You won't find it anywhere because the trick is that you have to have the device connected in order to see it. So I'm going to plug in an iPhone here, and when I do, I'll get the iPhone listed here on the left sidebar. If you don't see this left sidebar, by the way, you can view show and hide sidebar right here. And it'll appear, and there it is with the import window, and I can import selected, I can import all new items. But also notice here in the upper left is an option to open photos for this device. If I uncheck this, now when I plug in this device, this iPhone 6, it won't automatically launch photos anymore. So it's that easy to disable this behavior. But you have to have the device connected. If it was a camera, if it was an iPad, you'd still have to have it connected, have it selected here, and then turn it off. And the setting is specific for that device. So this doesn't change, say, my iPad and how Photos app would behave when I plug that in. It's just for the iPhone 6 Plus that I own. Now you do have even more control than the simple on-off function. If you run the app that comes with your Mac called Image Capture, I'm going to use Spotlight Manager to search for it. It's in the Applications folder. I run Image Capture, I'll see my device listed there on the left as well. And there's a little toggle here at the bottom to bring up this option here, and it tells me what happens when this device is attached. And now I have it set to launch no application, which makes sense. I've turned this off, but I can select photos here and it will change the behavior here. So it doesn't reflect it right away, but if I were to relaunch photos it would. I could set it to no application here. I can also set it to another app if I wanted to, or even select any app I want if I have some sort of third-party photo archiving application. So this is a way to have even more control over choosing specifically what happens when a device like a camera or an iPhone is plugged in. So what about iTunes? If you've got iTunes automatically launching when you plug in your iPhone or iPad, that's because you've got it set to automatically sync every time you've plugged it in. And this could be useful for a lot of people, but if you are plugging in your device several times a day, maybe this gets in the way and you want to turn it off. So just like with Photos, you need to plug in the device and then you can go and locate it here. Click on that and you should get all of the information about your device here on the left. Select Summary, and at the bottom, you scroll to the bottom of this and you get Options. And the first option is Automatically Sync when this iPhone is connected. That is what makes iTunes automatically launch when you connect the device. Turn that off. And now you have to do it manually. Now don't forget to do it. Don't forget to sync your device and back it up on a regular basis, of course. But this will save you the trouble of it automatically launching iTunes every single time you plug in the device.